Hello my dear students, hope you all are doing well at home. Today we are going to discuss question answers of chapter number 1, that is nutrition in plants, in which we have already learnt about the nutrition, mode of nutrition, photosynthesis, requirements of photosynthesis and how the plants use to prepare their food. So let's start with question number 1, that is what is nutrition. Nutrition is simply not taking the food. Nutrition is eating the food, digesting it and further utilizing the food for the growth, for the repair of the cells. Then it is termed as nutrition. Next comes, what is stomata and where does it found? Stomata are tiny pores present on the surface of leaf. They are present on both the side of leaf, upper side also and the lower side also, but the number of stomata are more on the lower side than the upper side. There are two functions of stomata. First is transpiration, that evaporation of water in the form of water vapors, and second, exchange of carbon dioxide and oxygen. Next comes, write the chemical equation for photosynthesis. See, to photosynthesis for photosynthesis to be performed, four requirements are there. One is carbon dioxide, second chlorophyll, third water, and the fourth is sunlight. If all the four conditions are available, then only a plant, a green autotroph, is able to perform the photosynthesis. So by using all the four factors, by using all the four requirements, a green plant or a autotroph used to make food in the form of carbohydrate, in the form of starch, along with a gas known as oxygen. Next comes, how does an insectivorous plant absorb nutrients from an insect trapped by it? See, insectivorous plant needs nitrogen, and to complete the deficiency of this nitrogen, they used to eat insects. There is a small pitcher plant in which it having a lid on it. What happens whenever a insect used to sit on it, the insect the lid closes and the insect moves inside the plant. There are little hairs around it, so the insect gets trapped into it, and he is not able to get out of that plant. The cells of the plant start secreting the digestive juices, and hence the insect got digest. That is how the plant completes the deficiency of nitrogen. Okay, next is, why is nitrogenous fertilizers not added in soil in which leguminous plants are grown? See, leguminous word, where it comes, it means root nodules are there. Root nodules means the swollen roots in which the rhizobium bacteria is present. Now, if the rhizobium bacteria is present into it, it itself will fix the nitrogen, then what is the need to give fertilizers? You tell? No need, na? That is why we are not giving fertilizers to it. Understood? Next, how does a saprophyte digest its food? See, saprophytes are the organisms which used to take the food from dead and decaying organic matter, like mushroom. So they just used to convert the solid part into the liquid and then used to take the nutrients from it. In this way, they used to take the nutrition from them. About next question, you all are well aware. That is autotrophs and heterotrophs. So what is the difference between autotrophs and heterotrophs? You all are knowing it. Autotrophs can prepare their food. Heterotrophs, whether they are herbivore, carnivore, omnivore, they cannot prepare their own food. So they are depending on the green plants because they can't perform photosynthesis. On the other side, autotrophs have chlorophyll, so they can perform the process of photosynthesis and can synthesize their own food, like algae, like green plants. And heterotrophs like us, like animals, cannot perform their own food. Next come, how will you test a leaf for a starch? See, starch is the end product of the photosynthesis, that is a carbohydrate. So if you want to test whether a leaf is having starch or not, you have to perform a simple activity. Firstly, boil the leaf into alcohol, it will remove the chlorophyll. Then boil the water into the lukewarm water, it will remove the alcohol. Then add 1 to 2 drop of iodine solution on the leaf. What will happen? If blue black color appears, it means the starch is there, and if blue black color doesn't comes, it means the starch is not there. Only one precaution you need to take care, that is don't boil the leaf excess in alcohol because it will destarch it. So when you will be adding the iodine solution, you won't be getting the blue black color. So this is a precaution you need to take care. Next is, how do plant get nitrogen? See, plant get nitrogen by two ways, either by the fixation or by the fertilizer. If the plant is leguminous, then root nodules will be having the rhizobium bacteria. They will be fixing the nitrogen. And if the plant is not having is not leguminous, then the farmers need to provide fertilizers to the soil to complete the life cycle in the presence of nitrogen. Next comes, all animals with the herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores depend on the plants for food. Discuss. Okay, you tell me first. Herbivores are those which used to take the food from plants. Carnivores, which eat herbivores, and omnivores, which eat carnivores as well as herbivores. So directly or indirectly, herbivores on the plants, carnivores on herbivores, which again on plant, and omnivores on carnivores and herbivores, which in turn again on plant. So all these are depending on the plant for their food. That is why we are saying that omnivores, carnivores, and herbivores all are depending on the food for depending on plants for food. Next comes the simple definitions. First is the parasitic. Parasites are those organisms which used to take food from other organisms which are living, and that living organisms are known as host. Those organisms either live inside the body or live outside the body. It can be a plant or it can be a animal. Like if we talk about plant parasite, that is cascata, and if we talk about animal parasite, that is lysis. So these all used to take nutrition from the living organisms. Next come the symbiosis. Symbiosis is a mutual relationship in which two organisms are there. How many? Two organisms which are mutually benefited. See, lichen is an example of symbiotic association in which one is algae, another is fungi. Algae being autotrophic can prepare their own food, fungi being heterotrophic cannot prepare their own food. So algae provide food to the fungi and fungi provide shelter to the algae. So both of them are benefited, right? So because both of them are benefited, this is a kind of mutual relationship. Saprophytic nutrition we have already discussed. Next comes, why manures and fertilizers are added to the soil. Manures are formed by the decomposition of plant and animal waste, whereas fertilizers are the chemicals. Manures doesn't provide nutrients to the plant, whereas fertilizers provide nutrients to the plant. Manures increases the water holding capacity. So water holding capacity is also essential. Again, humus is also important and nutrients are also important. So to provide both the benefits, farmers used to provide manure and fertilizers both to the soil in the farms. Coming to the last question, that is differentiate between parasites and partial parasites. Parasites are those organisms I already told you which take food and nutrition from the living organism, and partial parasites are those organisms which take only water. As they are, they contain chlorophyll, they can perform the process of photosynthesis, they are autotroph, but they are not able to take water from the soil, so they used to take water from another plants. That is known as partial parasite. Example of partial parasite is Xanthellum, and the example of parasites, complete parasites, are Cascata. Hope students, you understood all the question answers. Do have a revision. Take care of yourself and your family, and